Good evening. It's Michael from Red Chair Diaries coming to you from my red bedroom in Nova Scotia, Canada. And I want to do a book commentary. Oops. I borrowed the ebook from the city library. The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. I think it's her first book. Probably no point in leaving that there. You probably can't see it. Anyway, I must say, you know, I'd seen that book around a bit. So it's not too old, 2 or 3 years old, I think. And when I saw it on the page of the library saying what other people are reading, and it was available, I decided to take a chance on it. Slow at the beginning, but you know what? I really, really liked it. I really liked it, and I'd like to say that I really liked it. I don't know how many pages it is. You'll have to look it up, because with these ebooks, you know, and the different font sizes, I never quite know how long they are. But it took quite a while to get through it, so it's a commitment. It takes place basically around the end of the 1800s, early 20th century. Jumps around in time quite a bit. But it doesn't tend to be confusing, because it doesn't seem to matter. You know, you have these concurrent stories playing out, even though one might be 3 years ahead of the other story. You know, you have a story taking place in America with a young man called Bailey. And then you have stories taking place basically in London, and then in the Night Circus itself, which travels around the world. So the Night Circus is a circus that... it's a different kind of circus and doesn't play during the daytime. It only opens up in the evening, goes past midnight, and has certain supernatural elements about it. And the characters, there's two main characters that are kind of involved in some kind of contest that's established by... a competition might be better. It's not really a contest, I guess. Some kind of strategy game. And they have supernatural abilities, or maybe I should say... I guess supernatural, magical abilities to, in some cases, change materials, like fix broken teacups. And it goes on to do much more than that, but to reconstitute matter... there's even a bit of teleportation in the book at some point. There's all kinds of things. And so the Night Circus becomes this sort of venue where this challenge is being played out between these two people. The book is very, very clean. Like, it's there's no swear words in it. It's written, I think... conceivably in the Edwardian manner, because it does take place around the time of the late Victorian era, the early Edwardian, Edward VII era. So you've got ladies with their long dresses, gentlemen with their top hats, things like that. It's all very formal and posh for the most part. If anything, it reminds me of when I read many, many, many years ago, going back 40 years probably, The French Lieutenant's Woman, or as it would by John Fowles, which would be called The French Lieutenant's Woman in the States. But in Canada and in England, Australia, it would be The French Lieutenant's Woman. And that was kind of written in a mock Victorian manner. So this might be a bit Edwardian. It's totally accessible. Chapters are really, really short. Characters are very, very interesting. The shadowy figures, it's sometimes hard to get a handle on exactly what's going on with them. If you've read the book Needful Things by Stephen King, and I read that many years ago, that was the 80s, I think. 80s or early 90s. I think the 80s. And that one has, you know, real evil people in it. This one doesn't really have evil people so much, but it has manipulators in it. Something like in Needful Things. What else can I say about it? So there's no curse words. It's suitable for readers of all ages. It's not a young adult book. It's not a kid's book. It's just an interesting book. And, you know, you can, anybody who likes to explore novels that have different themes, non-run-of-the-mill events, I highly recommend it. But it's slow starting, but stick with it, and you'll like it. It's The Night Circus. It's with a supernatural bent, but it is not a horror story. It's not scary. It's atmospheric. That's what it is. So I really, really enjoyed it immensely. It's a complete surprise to me, and it's so nice to be surprised in your reading. Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and I will see you around the tube.